is happening, you know that the kingdom of God is near. So God says, check the trees out. Not only the olive tree, but all the trees. And I think that's why the Holy Spirit put an emphasis on trees. Herman didn't call me to tell me what he was preaching on, but God had put it on him to speak about trees. And he did this incredible research on trees. And we all were blessed by it. Because God, why did we spend the whole weekend speaking about trees? Because the church needs to become wise and understand trees. Because God uses trees to even speak to us about his second coming. And if you don't know how to discern a tree, when the fig leaves, when the fig tree blossoms with leaves, you will know that the summer is near, that the kingdom of God is near. So God is preparing us so that we understand the time and the seasons. Let me give you a few more verses before I end, because I want to end back in the Garden of Eden. But before that, go with me to Judges chapter 9. In Judges chapter 9, listen to this parable of the trees, spoken by a man in the Old Testament, because God is consistent with revelation. The people of the Old Testament knew something about nature and the trees, and God could use trees to speak about men. So in Judges chapter 9, verse 7, we'll start with verse 7 and go on. Judges chapter 9, are you with me tonight? Amen. Judges chapter 9, verse 7, when Jotham, here's the man who's speaking, was told about this, he climbed up on the top of a mountain of Gerizim and shouted to them, listen to me, citizens of Shechem, so that God may listen to you. And then he goes on. One day the trees went out to anoint a king for themselves, and they said to the olive tree, be our king. But the olive tree answered, should I give up my oil, by which both gods and men are honored, to hold sway over the trees, to wave at other trees? Next the tree said to the fig tree, come and be our king. But the fig tree replied, should I give up my fruit, so good and sweet, to hold sway over the trees? Then the trees said to the vine, come and be our king. But the vine answered, should I give up my wine, which cheers both gods and men, to hold sway over the trees? Finally, all the trees said to the thorn bush, come and be our king. Now they went from the trees to a thorn bush. You come and be our king. The thorn bush said to the trees, if you really want to anoint me king over you, come and take refuge in my shade. But if not, then let fire come out of the thorn bush and consume the cedars of Lebanon. Now, this was a wrong choice that the people of Shechem made over a king that wanted the kingship by his own strength. And he was voted in as a half-brother of this man who's speaking this parable. After he killed 69 of his brothers, only one of them escaped. And it was Jotham who escaped to speak this parable. He says, if you take him as your king, you'll be like a thorn bush, not like one of these trees. But the important part of this, he makes reference to all the trees, these different trees, the fig tree, the vine. All of them had a function. Every tree has a function. Every tree has got a purpose. Every tree in this room has a divine purpose. You started the retreat speaking about the purpose of God. God has a purpose for every single person. Maybe some of you will be like a fig tree. Some of you will be like David, an olive tree. Some of you will be like an apple tree, just like Jesus, sweet to the taste. Maybe some of you will be like the vine, producing wine, cheering up people. A few comedians among you, maybe. People with a good sense of humor. We need them in the church. Can you say amen? How many know the church needs to laugh once in a while and be able to enjoy? This is the kingdom of God, and we should have life and life more abundantly. But the point is that every tree has its place. Do not leave or abandon your place for a position that man might offer you. Did you hear that? You have a special place. Once you find a place, Once you discover what kind of tree you are, stay in the place. Don't exchange it for anything else. Stay in your place. You were created with purpose. You were created with strength. You were created with seeds of success, like you've already heard. And God wants to use you the way you are. He doesn't want you to be me. He doesn't want you to be Brother Herman. He wants you to be you. Amen? Every one of you is unique. You have a divine purpose and a divine job in the kingdom of God. Somebody give God a praise in this place. Come on. God made you special. He made you unique. Now let's move on as we close up here, because the book of Judges is full of the word of the Lord. And I like what Job has to say about trees, because maybe some of you have been met with by the woodcutters of life that tried to cut you down. And maybe there are tragic things that have happened in your life that cut you down, and you became just a stump. Maybe you arrived in Memphis, Tennessee, like a stump. No branches, just a stump. Job chapter 14 speaks about the hope of a stump. Listen to it. Job chapter 14, verses 7 and 9. Job chapter 14, verses 7 through 9. 7 through 9. At least there is hope for a tree. If it is cut down, it will sprout again. Somebody say, it'll sprout again. And its new shoots will not fail. Keep going. Verse 8. Its root may grow old. Its roots may grow old in the ground. Its stump die in the soil. Yet at the scent of water, it will bud and put forth shoots like a plant. At the scent. Everybody say at the scent. At the smell of water, at the scent, a whiff of water, and a dry, dead tree stump will come alive. There's hope for everyone in the kingdom of God. No matter what tragedy has touched your life, no matter who cut you down, if you are still here alive, if you're in Memphis, Tennessee right now in a going strong retreat, amen, there is hope for you. The scent of water. How many know the word of God is like water? It comes down. The teaching of the Lord is like water. That's why we spend time in the word, because God wants to revive you. He wants to quicken you. He wants to bring you back. He wants to bring the shoots back out of you. Amen? There's hope for every stump. No matter how low you've been cut down, God can revive the stump. Amen? Somebody say there's hope for every stump. You'll find people in your life, trees, that will be cut down. Some of your ministry here will be to stumps. Some of you will be stump revivers. Hello? You're going to go back into your city, back into your towns, and you're going to find some people who have been cut down. Dare to speak the word of God will be like water to them. At the scent of water, they'll come back to life. At the scent of the presence of God, the water of God's presence will bring them back to life. I'm telling you that there is the power of resurrection residing in this conference, and you're going to go back with the power to cause things that are dead to come back to life. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. I recently met a man while I was in Indonesia. I met a man in Singapore, traveling to Singapore in a conference. They call him a miracle man, a man who raises the dead. And he has conferences. He's an evangelist who has conferences raising the dead and reviving people that are dead. He has raised multiple dead people in his ministry. And I asked him, I got alone with him. I asked him, how did this happen? Where did you get that anointing? And he said, my grandmother, and then he shared it as well with the conference, is my grandmother was an old woman who got saved with a missionary that visited our village in Africa. And she got saved and got filled with the Holy Spirit. How many of you are filled with the Holy Ghost? Come on, you need the power of the Holy Spirit. He said she got filled with the Holy Spirit and nothing became impossible for her. She began to pray for people and people would get healed. And she began to really become a woman who believed in miracles. And one day as a little boy, I had a little chick and it died, a little chicken, and it died. And I brought her my chick to my grandmother and she looked at it and I said, Grandma, my chicken is dead. My little chick is dead. And she looked at him and said, Son, nothing dies around me. And she laid hands on the chicken and restored it. It came back to life. And he said, ever since then, the anointing hit me. I have that anointing to resurrect the dead. And he goes about filling stadiums with thousands of people and resurrecting the dead. Well, I believe the same anointing that was in Jesus is at work in us. Can you say amen? The Bible says so. You have the power to bring things back to life. Are you ready to resurrect some dead stumps in your city? Are you ready to resurrect some dead people in your family? Maybe cut down by false religion, cut down by false prophets, cut down by tragedy, cut down by economics. I believe God wants to restore people. He wants to revive people who were dead in the ground. They're just a stick in the mud. But once the power of God hits them, they're going to come alive. They're going to find themselves worshiping God. They're going to someday bring forth shoots and fruit and branches. Can you say amen? Come on, give the Lord a clap. God wants to use you to revive those stumps. The Bible is full of great examples. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 13 says, as long as the stump remains, there's hope. Isaiah 6, verse 13, speaking about Jesus. Listen to it. And though a tenth remains in the land, it will again be laid waste. But as the terebinth and oak leaf stumps, when they are cut down, so the holy seed will be the stump in the land. The holy seed will be in the stump. Genesis says that every fruit-bearing tree has seed in itself. There is seed in the stump. The holy seed will be in the stump. I want to tell you that there's some families and some people that are backslidden, that have heard the gospel but backslidden and got cut down by the enemy. And they're no longer in the church. Can I tell you, there's still hope for them. There is the seed, the holy seed. The incorruptible word of God is still in them. There's a holy seed in the stump. God will bring back the backslidden. Are you ready to see some backsliders come back home? Are you ready to see them be revived again? I'm telling you prophetically that you're going to see a harvest of backsliders. Well, let me end by telling you this, that God would ask you, what tree would you compare yourself with? Herman started by